I'm Dean Cefola, and this is the Azure Academy.
We all need some way to connect to the cloud, and sometimes that's over the internet or the Azure portal, sometimes that's through a express route or site-to-site VPN, and sometimes that means a point-to-site VPN or client-based VPN. When you're using one of these kind of solutions, you might be currently using a third-party vendor's product, and you wish you could move into Azure, but there's just not support for Azure AD integration or MFA support or a way that you can make it more secure than what Azure has offered. Well, today your wishes have been granted because at Ignite there were some great announcements, and one of them involves how to secure your client-based VPNs. And we're going to talk about that today here at the Azure Academy. So if you haven't done so already, please do click on our subscribe button and join us here at the Azure Academy community, where we all just are trying to learn all about Azure. And please give us some comments below if you have any questions on this video or anything else, as well as things that you'd like us to cover in the future. There are a lot of announcements from Ignite that we're trying to get through, so it'll be kind of a first come, first serve. So put in your requests and we'll make videos. So let's jump right over to the Azure documentation.
So the documentation that we want to look at is under products. And when you click products, you can see we've got kind of a new layout here. So looking at the all services right away, then over on the left, we can still navigate down to networking, or you could just find what you're looking for in the list, which is going to be VPN gateway. And there it is under networking. So when we open that up, we've got a new layout here for the main documentation section. And what we want is under the how-to guide. And this is going to be for point-to-site connections. What we have enabled in the past was the ability to set up a Radius server that would allow you to integrate with Azure MFA so that you could do multi-factor authentication, but not exactly Azure AD authentication. Now we have Azure AD authentication without the need of a Radius server, which will use your Azure built-in MFA if that's something that you want to do. So the three docs that we're going to be spending our time on today is creating our tenant, multi-factor, and creating our VPN client. So in order for this to work, we already need to have a virtual network and gateway stood up. So if we go to the Azure portal, I've already got a resource group created for my VPN, and I've already got a virtual network created. So this virtual network needs to have a subnet called Gateway Subnet in order for you to be able to provision the gateway service. Now that we've got that already in place, we'll click Add and then type in our search here, Virtual Network Gateway, and we'll click on the search results and click the Create button. So walking through the build experience here, we have to select our subscription, which probably is selected for you already, and we need to give our gateway a name. I'll just call mine VPN Gateway 1, and then a region. I'll be in the East US. So our gateway type will be VPN because we're building a client-based VPN. Now we need to select our VPN type. So we do need a route-based VPN for this. Now, as far as the SKUs go, we're going to scroll down just a little bit here. So the number of SKUs have increased from what we've had in the past. We used to only have 1, 2, and 3. Now we've also got 4 and 5. And we also have another set of 1 through 5 with AZ. So this is if you want to deploy a gateway into availability zones. Now, the benefit of availability zones is that they provide another layer of high availability and somewhat of a layer of disaster recovery at the Azure resource level. Specifically, all of our regions, like East US, have multiple data centers in them. There are some Azure regions that have multiple availability zones, and that's where we take segments of those data centers that are geographically located together within the region, and then we link them as a zone. So your resource could end up in one of the four data centers that are in zone 1, or the data centers that are in zone 2 or zone 3, however many zones that particular region has. So for this deployment, I just need to get this up and running. So I don't need a very fast or high performant gateway or one that allows a lot of connections like 3, 4, and 5 would. So I'm just going to choose the availability zone gateway 1. So that way I have at least some high availability protection for my resources. Now we need to select the virtual network that we're going to use, and I've already got that here. It's VNet1, and it's pre-populated my gateway subnet address. And now we need a public IP address, will be where all of our users will connect to. And I'll name it similar to my gateway just to keep the resources connected together. And we'll scroll down a little bit more. And now we have to select our availability zones. Now, because we have chosen a gateway that's in zones, we have multiple options. And that's also because East US happens to have three zones. You may be in another region that only has two zones. So I can choose to pin this resource to zone 1, zone 2, or zone 3. It would do all of its scale up inside that zone alone. But I also have the option, which is what I'm going to choose, of zone redundant. And zone redundant means that it will be able to scale out across all three zones. Okay, so it gives me some more high availability. Now, another level of high availability is whether or not you want to have active. So the gateway by default is active passive in its deployment. So you get at least two appliances spun up in the background, and they'll be in zone redundant form. So one will be in zone 1, for example. The other one might be in zone 3. It just depends on the load that's in the zones at the time. But I can choose to make them both active or all active. If my scale requires it, the system would span into all three zones with multiple appliances, however much I need, and they would all be active, all accepting connections. And this becomes important if you have a high amount of users, say up to 1,000 users that you want to connect through this kind of service. But in my case, I do not need active, so I'll leave this disabled. And another way to control traffic flow is through configuring your BGP, which is your border gateway protocol. I am going to leave that turned off at the moment because this is just a test for this video, but that is a good practice if you want to control your routing and traffic flow a little bit more. So I'll hit next here and we'll provide a tag, and this will be for our cost center so we know who's paying for all of this. And then we'll hit our review button and our validation has passed, so we know that we should be able to build this resource no problem. And we'll hit create. So our gateway finished deploying in roughly 15 minutes. And let's go to our resources now. And we can see that it is a route-based gateway with a SKU that's in an availability zone. We've got the network it's tied to, the public IP that it's tied to. And then we can look under the configuration if we needed to ever change our SKU or change our active or enable BGP. And so now, in order to make it a point-to-site configuration, we would normally go here and configure our point-to-site and all of that. But because we want to integrate this with Azure Active Directory and possibly MFA, we've got some other things we've got to do first instead. Now, in the docs under the Configure a Tenant link, we need to first authorize our Azure VPN over Azure Active Directory. So we're going to need our directory ID. And so that is under the properties of Azure Active Directory, and we could copy that out, which I've already done in the background. And then there is a link here that we have to run in order to be able to build our enterprise application that we'll be using to connect Azure AD with our VPN. And as you can see, this is available in the public, government, German, and China clouds. So this should basically be available for everyone everywhere. So I'll open this in a new tab. And when we do, we've got to sign in. And that needs a global administrator in order to do this step. And if you do not have global admin access, then you're going to need to find the person who does in your org. And then you can see more details of what this app is going to do here. And I'll just hit accept. And if we go to Azure Active Directory now, and we go to Enterprise Applications, we can see the Azure VPN. Now, the enterprise app experience has been updated recently, so it looks a little bit different than you may have seen it in the past. So we've got our name, application, and object IDs here at the top, and then a getting started section. And one of the first things that I like to do with all my enterprise apps is assign an owner. And this is because it's the owner who's responsible for the app. And that way, if there's ever a question of what's going on with any owners in the future, you can always find out who they are and go back to them and say, you know, what's going on with this or that. Now, under the users and groups, we're also going to need to assign the users that we want to have access to our VPN. So we'll click Add User and then select some of our users, and then we'll hit Select, and they will be given default access to the application, and they are now assigned. So now let's look at the properties blade.
And a few things that we just want to validate are turned on, and that is that this is enabled for users to sign in. So that should be yes. And then also that the user assignment is required. We want to say yes to that and save. So if you're going to use multi-factor auth, what we do need to do here is verify that you have the right licenses or that you have security defaults enabled. MFA has in the past been a licensable feature. So if you did not have a P1 or P2 license or Office 365 Azure AD license, you did not have multi-factor auth. However, we made it a free feature if you turn on security defaults. So in the blade, we're going to go to properties, and then at the bottom, manage security defaults. And then we're going to switch that to yes, and we'll hit save. So I'll go back to my main Azure AD screen and go to my users. So I'll click on the multi-factor auth link. And now under the multi-factor, it's a additional how should we contact you? And this could be done through a mobile app. So with the security defaults, the free version, we don't have a whole lot of options to enable MFA. So you've just got to go with that. If you want more options, then you do need to go to the premium feature SKU. So I'll receive notifications for my verification and I'll push setup. I need to now use my phone in order to be able to scan this QR code. So let me turn on my phone here and I'll start my Microsoft Authenticator app. And then we'll add a new authenticator for a work account. And so I'll log in. And there you can see MFA has now been set up in my authenticator. So we can hit next. And now we've got to enter our verification code from the mobile app. And then we'll click verify. So validation has been successful. And if you want to learn more about how to do MFA, there is a video link up here that you can go watch as well. So we'll hit done. And now MFA has been set up. So now I can proceed with using MFA with my Azure AD login for my VPN. But first we have to configure the VPN gateway to accept such a login. So we'll go back to our Azure docs. And underneath the Enable Azure AD Authentication on VPN Gateway step, we've got some code blocks here, and we need to edit some details from this code. So I've already done this in my notepad. And the first thing we need to do is specify the VPN Gateway's name and resource group, which I've done as VPN Gateway 1 and VPN. And then we also need to add our Azure AD tenant information. For that, in this last line of the code, we see that we have to take this login and add our directory tenant ID. Now, further up in the doc, it tells us where to find that in the properties blade of the Azure AD portal. And there's your directory ID that you can copy and then put into your notepad. Then we have to enter that same thing again at the end of the line as well for our Azure AD issuer URI. So I've completed those steps and now I can execute this code in PowerShell, or I can click on the try it button, which is going to open up a Cloud Shell for us. So I'll hit sign in and then I'll log in with my account and it'll start up my Cloud Shell. And if you don't have one already, it'll prompt you to create a Cloud Shell, which is really just an Azure storage account. And inside our Cloud Shell here, we're going to paste that command with the edits that we've made. So we'll right click and paste. And now that we've completed that, we can see under our VPN client configuration section, we're using the OpenVPN protocol. And then we also have our Azure AD tenant ID listed here, as well as the issuer ID, which should match our tenant ID. And then we have the Azure AD audience parameter, which relates to the Azure VPN app ID. So now that all of that is complete, we need to run another command. And that is the next one here, where we're going to get the VPN client configuration. And we need to change this code to provide the name of our gateway and resource group. And then we can leave the rest of this code alone. And this second line is going to give us the URL from which we can download the package. So we'll run that code. Okay, and there is our URL to download the code. And it is a zipped file. So we can just click on that link. And there is our configuration. So let's open that up. And I've saved that into a folder here for Azure AD VPN.
And inside there is our zip file. And you just want to make sure that you unblock it. Otherwise, you'll have files that are individually blocked. And then we'll extract it to this location. And we get two folders. So in this generic folder is a root cert and a VPN settings XML file. And the one that we're interested in is in the Azure VPN folder. And this is our VPN client configuration. Now what we need to do is we need to download the VPN agent in order to make use of this file. So for that, back in our documentation, we can scroll down here to the next step, which is configure a VPN client. That'll take us to the third doc in the link, to which we can then click this download link, which will take us out to the Microsoft Store so that we can download the VPN client. And we'll click on Get here. And then this is redirecting us to the store app. So that's okay to allow. And then we need to click the install button, and you might need to provide credentials. And it just takes a second to download and install. And now that it's installed, we can hit the launch button here, or it's also listed under your start menu as Azure VPN client. I'll hit launch. So before we import our connection, I want to show you where the steps are in the docs. So right where we found that download link in this configure a VPN client, this is talking about how to walk through this in different ways. And this section that we want, which is importing our client. And the important thing when you import that VPN config file is that we end up with authentication type Azure Active Directory. All right, so let's take a look at how that goes. So we'll hit our plus button and do an import, and we'll navigate to our Azure AD VPN. And open the client folder and Azure VPN and click on our client XML and hit open. And now we can rename this connection if we want to. The VPN server that's here, we don't need to touch, as well as the root cert or secret. Those have all been provided from the XML. We have Azure Active Directory for authentication type. And then we can see that our tenant information, application ID for the Azure AD VPN and issuer are all in here correct. And we can hit save, and we are ready to attempt a connection. So we'll hit the connect button. And since I have multiple profiles on my system, I'll choose the one that I want to connect with and hit continue. And we see that we are already connected. Okay? And we can see that in the tail log at the bottom as well. And we see we've got the IP address of 172.18.10.2. And we can verify that in our command prompt by doing IP config. And there is our IP address for our VPN connection. So I hope that you've enjoyed looking at how to set up point-to-site connections, finally being able to leverage Azure Active Directory authentication, even with multi-factor authentication, if that is a requirement for you. And this should be able to help folks move away from third-party providers and appliances, which can be quite expensive, in order to move to a native cloud solution that can meet those same requirements. So if you thought that this video was good, please do click on that thumbs up icon, and that lets the YouTube algorithm know that you liked our content and it should be shared with others. And while you're down there, please click on that subscribe button and join us here at the Azure Academy community. And if you are interested in getting an email when our videos come out, which is roughly once a week, then you can click on that notification bell. And please do leave us a comment down below on any questions that you have, or feedback, or maybe even a feature that you'd like to see added to our VPN SKUs, and then we can all make Azure better. So thanks very much for joining us today, and we'll see you next time. Happy learning.